just gives you an idea here. Eddie, you know, the technician, whined until music shuts off and followed Chip, whined on John's entrance. This is just basically cues. You don't have to follow it directly, but John then does an overture, a musical overture. That's the so medium shot. John, then shine. There, then shine, that's a shoe shine boy, and widen on entrance when he starts the thing because we get his entrance, he jumps in, then medium shot on Chip, full frame on Chip, follow Chip. Then Jacques, two shots, John and Chip in frame, a little bit at the beginning, because Jacques messed up with the microphone, then close on Chip. Football is amazing, this is wide, old man, Chip, full frame with the audience assistant, that makes sense. John does another circle, another piano thing, medium shot on piano. Chaz mostly bounces, you know, we've got the full frame, follow until the end of New York, New York, and white and white, and he's playing this, I've explained
this. Because this is a view made here, this is made here,
yeah.
And this is why.
Yeah.
Okay, so you just
okay, but my problem is that I am not going to be here directly all the time because I'm going to be on stage.
Well, I'm trying to follow this.
Just try to follow it. I mean, and then otherwise just try to make sense. Just, you know, whatever makes sense to you, you know, stuff like that. You know?
The best is if I was moving the trunk, for the push-ups.
Well, I know. It's just, I mean, I know we only have one camera. We do what we can. We have a lot of people. You can see we have more people than we normally have. So it's going to be...
I can do is zoom.
Yes, exactly. That's all it is. That's, you know, I mean, you know, not only the blue shop, but, you know, it's basically two people in the frame, basically. That's what I find. So, you know, here, that happens. Okay, we have a band playing. You know, it's that obviously. Boy, otherwise, you're fine.
I'll go on. But this section is broken.
So we have to argue.
Don't
say. Arguing about who is supposed to sing.
You make a good
argument.
This one is
somebody out there. This person is going to be in
the table. You must have been in the
so, what I'd like to say is that I'm going to be in the I know, but set two is over here. We have blues, which you know.
Well, do we have time to start?
Not very much, because I'm going to be in this piece, and I'm going to be in this piece, and I haven't even done it. So I don't, my costume, I have no time to do anything. It's been just one hell situation. So,
yeah, okay, I'm following you.
Where are all these people coming from? Hey, Greg.
Hi, sweetie.
All right, but you want to just keep this with you. I didn't make a copy of this. I'm upset. I'll try to come back in the break.
I'll study this a little bit. It's very important.
But Alex is here on the video, so good to see you too. You'll have to excuse me because I got two things that I gotta do right now. I know. Yeah, do we know what
that's alright, just wait for that. Just free the whole time.
It's just the beginning. It's just when Chip's doing the microphone and John's doing the same. Once he starts to speak, just go right on Chip. That's the why. Yes, it's a whole different action.
Do I have time between this John knocking?
He's talking. He introduces quickly. This is all about.
This doesn't look important because I've changed lenses.
Not necessarily, we can miss it, it's okay. Hey, it's on your way. Yeah, it's good, Emma. So you could, yeah, he starts after he finishes, he goes down to the whole. That's great, that's a good one. That's a song. It's basically getting good.
Thank you. Rick, the music should be on at this time.
I know the music should be on.
Keep the music rolling, okay?
Well, the music is rolling.
Right.
Keep the volume.
What?
I think you have to turn up the volume just a little
wait
bit.
Wait a minute. Why don't you check the speakers, Eddie?
Speakers, Eddie?
No. You're Eddie. You check the speakers.
Where are the speakers, Rick?
What's that, Eddie?
No speakers.
Well, if there are no speakers, then they can't be possibly be the problem.
Okay.
Well, if there's no...
There should be some sound on some...
Oh, wait, now, of course, Eddie, it's... check the tape. The tape. No. Not that tape. The tape in your cassette recorder.
Oh, shit. Sorry, how stupid. Which side?
See if you can find side B.
All right, testing. Can everybody see me?
No.
Okay, good afternoon. I'd like to welcome everybody here to the Lido. My name is Eddie Norton. You can call me Sweaty Eddie or Snortin' Norton. I'll be the master technician for tonight's show, so I can assure you all there'll be absolutely no technical problems.
Okay, the way the show starts is I stand up here and have to talk to one.
Okay, like I said, the way the show starts is I have to run through the public with a few kind of cash one to what the hell is going on. Yeah, 1, 2. Right, that wasn't a technical problem. That was just a common fuck up. It happens all the time. Right, now my job as a professional masturbator is to master technician is to make sure that the public is good, because if the public is good, that means that the show is good. Okay. Now if the public is bad, that means that I don't get paid tonight, and I've got a family at home to support. No, seriously, I've got a kid and three wives to support. I mean, three wives and a kid. And so it's my job to make sure that you're all really good. Okay? So I want to start right now by going through what we call laugh, okay? But first, is everybody feeling all right?
Yeah!
No, you don't have to answer. This is not a rock and roll concert, okay? It's just a simple comedy thing, okay? On the count of three, I want everyone to give me the sound of a laugh using the words ha-ha, ho-ho, or hee-hee, okay? No hoo-hoos. Ho-ho, ha-ha, hee-hee, okay? 1, 2, 3. Okay. Now, if this were 10 years ago and we were in the Milky Way, that would be okay. Right now, I'm going to pass out some of these laughing drugs, okay? Just take them, swallow them, and, oh yeah, by the way, don't eat the yellow ones, all right? Okay, now try some of these. Oh, sorry about that. Charge it to the leader, it's okay. All right, now on the count of three, maybe if you don't want to use ha-ha-ho, that's okay. Try things like ha-ha, marvelous, ha-ha, wonderful, ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha. Shit. Okay, let's try it again. 1, 2, 3. Okay, not bad for amateurs. All right, at the end, the show is made up into sketches. During the sketches, you have to laugh. At the end of the sketches, we have applause, okay? Does everyone know what applause is? Raise your right hand if you know what applause is. Right hand if you know. Okay, now put the other one up. And now bring them together like that. Yeah. All right. Shit, goddamn, your experience. What a pump. All right, now, I'm going to begin the show now by bringing out our piano player. His name is John Bickersteth, and it's his birthday tonight, okay? It's also Chip Ray's birthday tomorrow. Chip Ray. He's a famous comedian here in Hempstead. Yeah? He makes a lot of money. He'd probably do a lot for your career. All right, so, ladies and gentlemen, just remember what I said, okay? Remember, big applause, some emotion, John's birthday today. Try to make him feel good, okay? Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to bring out the performing backstar professional musician from the Chip Ray Mr. Monday Night Show. Will you please welcome the one and only Mr. John Bickersteth? Come on, everybody.
Thank you.
I'm born. You know, when I was a little boy, I was a tiny, tiny little boy with a tiny head and a tiny butt. But I had a mama who was big as a mountain. We used to call her K2. She was big. And every morning, my mama used to pick me up in her big mountain arms. And she used to say,
"Son, what you want to be when you grow up, huh? Doctor?"
I said, "No, mama, I don't want to be no doctor."
"Well, what you want to be then, huh? A lawyer?"
I said, "No, mama, I don't like lawyers." Now, you see, my mama had a very serious hormonal problem. Too much testosterone. Testosterone coming out of her ears, out of her nose, out of her mouth, out of her beard, everywhere.
Quit talking about my female problems, boy. You tell me what you want to be.
No, mama, don't hit me. No, don't hit me, mama. Mama, mama, mama. I want to be a shoe shine boy.
A shoe shine boy? Well, everybody think you look stupid shining shoes.
Mama, I don't care. I don't care if everybody think I look stupid. Don't diss me again, mama. Here's how I figure it. Well, just because my hair is curly, and just because my teeth are pearly, just because I always wear a smile, it's to dress up in the latest style, and just because I'm glad I'm living. Trouble smiling, never whine, just because my talent's rated slightly lower, maybe that's why they call me shiny. Say, just because my face looks funny, and just because I ain't got no money, just because I always keep my cool, learning to stay young, never play the fool, and dress me as I'm always laughing. Put hard earned money to good use. I'm reputated to have never been, but that's why I'll shine your shoes. Take it, Barry! Alright, listen to me, everybody. You gotta get your shoes up on the ass so I can clean them up!
Come on, let's go! Let me see what you got.
From the world of light entertainment to the world of international politics. Thank you, as we are about to bring to you the greatest political thinker on the political scene at the political moment. Ladies and gentlemen, I think I've got a technical problem. Well, yes, I have got a technical problem. Help me! Anybody, please! Help! Well, I'll just have to have a look around, see if I can find something wrong.
John.
Why don't you check the cable?
Volume control down. Eh? What stupid bloody fool turned the volume control down? I'm the only one who's been up here. So, ladies and gentlemen, finally, to turn back to the world of international politics, here is a great political speaker, a great political thinker, and in greed. And indeed, a great politician. From Belgium, will you please welcome Mr. Jacques Brie! Good ladies, evening, and gentlemen. Good evening, ladies and Germanies. Dag allemaal. That's Dutch. Can you say hi, Jacques Brie?
Hi, Jacques Brie.
Hi. Thank you for saying that. I like the way your lips move when you say hi, Jacques Brie. Hi, Jacques Brie. It's really fun to watch. You know, I speak to you tonight not as a Belgian man speaking English or as an Englishman speaking Belgian, but as a European man speaking English who says he's Belgian but is really American. Remember, we are all Europeans first, and in your case, Dutch people second. No, really, what was Ruud Lubbers before he was the Prime Minister of Holland?
I know that one. Huh? He worked at McDonald's at the light supply.
No, he was a European. And what was John Major before he was the Prime Minister of Great Britain?
He was a lager lad.
No, before that.
Bus driver?
But no, he wasn't qualified. A European! It's so simple. What was Kurt Waldheim before he was the Secretary General of the United Nations?
A Nazi.
Right, a Nazi. We're all Nazis.
No, European!
Oh, yeah, European. European, Amapian. Yeah, as a matter of fact, European down your pants. I have a dream. Ask not what your country can do for you, but ask what you can do for me. I mean, read my hips. The bus stops here. Remember the Alamo. Ich bin ein Berlinerwurst. Baby, I want to hold your hand. You ain't nothing but a hound dog. Let's spend the night together. Anyway, last night, when I was walking high up there on those giant, giant Dutch Alps, hey, it was my dream. I had a dream where I saw people from all different countries living together. I saw Dutch people living with Italian people. I saw English people living with Spanish people. I saw French people living with French people. Now, forget the French. But I saw almost all the people from all the different countries living together under one
notes.
Living together under one roof, flying one flag, worshiping one dog, God, spending one money. Buy one package of condoms, two jars of Vaseline, a bunch of cheap presents for Chip Ray's birthday party and from the Hema, four cases of champagne, three cases of
this is mine.
Are there any questions? I have a question, okay. If they call the people from Poland Poles, why don't they call the people from Holland Holes? Germany germs? Just a thought. You know, a lot of people come up to me all the time and they say, Jacques, is that a pen in your pocket? Or are you just happy to see me? Well, yes, I'm happy to see you. And yes, it is a pen in my pocket. But it's not just an ordinary pen. This is the ultimate in ink. This is the new Euro pen. The new Euro pen is a Spanish invention designed by the Germans and built by the British. It's calibrated to a French satellite using Greek software with a Dutch modem and an Italian fax. It's powered by Danish batteries and has a Portuguese titanium coating which makes it waterproof under any Belgian lake up to 200 meters down. So, these will be available after my speech absolutely free for only 50 euro dollars. Well, folks, remember not to forget that Jean-Brie is the man who will make tomorrow's past better than yesterday's future used to be today. Oh well, it doesn't matter what I say, as long as you vote for me. That's my speech, folks. Good night, everyone. Don't forget to vote for me.
Thank you
very much, ladies and gentlemen.
Now, we come to the very cultured and sophisticated part of tonight's show. No one... stoned or something. No doubt, many of you will be familiar with the very interesting works of the great Russian novelist Dostoevsky. Yes, indeed, his great works include Brothers Karamazov, something else, that great novel, The Idiot. Yes. But tonight, ladies and gentlemen, another of Dostoevsky's great masterpieces. Tonight, Dostoevsky's great novel, The Old Man and the Light Bulb!
Thank you.
ladies and gentlemen, looking at the running order, actually, there's nothing next. So I think I'll have a cigarette break. Please smoke if you'd like.
Thank you, I love me. You are so beautiful to be. Hello everybody, it's Jango. Don't I have a great tune? You are so beautiful to be. Can't you see? Everything is beautiful in its own way. Come on, clap your hands. I love the story summer night. A roller in the hay. Hey, you're good clappers. To thank all the lovely people here in the Lido for inviting me to your wonderful town of Skippo. This beautiful city of Düsseldorf, where are those? Hammersport. Rotterdam. Does that ring a bell? Something down. Anyway, you know, before I get into my long speech right now, I just want to say that I have fans all over the world, and they just can't keep their hands off of me. I mean, if you look closely, you'll see that my entire body from head to toe is covered with love bites. Mostly them self-inflicted. But seriously, before I came here to Amsterdam, I had to spend hours and hours reading all of my Amsterdam fan mail letters. I'd like to share this fan mail letter with you. It's real. It's addressed to Chasmo. It starts off, "Dear Chasmo, you are so beautiful. I love to watch you sing because I love the way your lips move. Can we please meet after the show, perhaps my place? Love, Jacques Brie." Sure, Jacques. But right now I have to move my lips. And I'd like to dedicate this song to all the beautiful, beautiful, to some of the beautiful people here in Amsterdam. Cities. And we have performed for over 27 million different people. And I just want to say this one thing about the lovely people here in Amsterdam. That is, you people here in Amsterdam are just the same as all the other people. and I wrote this song for you.
A part of it in Amsterdam. These vagabond shoes are longing to stay. Right through the very heart of it in Amsterdam. I want to wake up to a city that never sleeps. And find out king of the hill.
If I can make it anywhere, what the hell am I doing here? But seriously, folks, this is your city, so it's your song. Huh? When I get to the part that says, in Amsterdam, I want everybody to sing, okay? Now let's just practice once, okay? On three. One, two, three.
In Amsterdam.
Okay, come on, you guys have been taking too many drugs, all right? Look. Lido, for God's sakes. One, two, three. Don't worry about the rhythm and don't worry about the music. You know, I never do. One, two, three. All right, that's beautiful. Let's put it to some music, boys.
Start spreading the news. I'm get ready. I want to be a part of it. These vagabond shoes are longing to stay right through the very heart of it.
Come on! I want to wake up to a city that never sleeps.
Yeah.
those little town blues.
Well, this is a surprise, to say the least. Ladies and gentlemen, Chasmo Senior! We're going to take a 15-minute break right now. So why don't you all go out there and have a drink, and drink some more, because the more you drink, the better we look.
No. Okay.
gift and it blew. Gonna get mad. Nobody loves me. Nobody loves me. Nobody wants me. Nobody wants me. Nobody needs me. Nobody at all. Sure, what I mean, boys, take me from that place. My mother, she left me in the middle of the street. From the gutter, body was incomplete. I looked in the mirror and saw my own face. I said, Jesus, thanks, Christ. I don't feel so good. I got the blues. But I don't just have the blues, I got the Amsterdam blues. You know what it's like to have the Amsterdam blues? That nobody loves you. Nobody. Not my mommy. Certainly not my daddy. And not the police. Every day it's raining in the sky and it's dark shitting on the ground. It's no fun being in Amsterdam. Where are you from, sir? Where? Is that in Amsterdam? Ah, poor guy. I know how it feels. England smells it. How do you feel tonight, sir? You don't have the blues? Not a pix. Does somebody love you? Is she sitting next to you?
Just might be.
Just might be. Oh, she's cute. Is that your wife or are you just having fun? I see. And how do you feel tonight? No blues? Does somebody love you too? You're not sure? Get your hand off her. Oh, what about this table? You two girls alone together. Do you guys love each other? Yeah. Oh! Look, love comes in many shapes and sizes. No, really. You can be heterosexual, you can be homosexual, bisexual. Look at me! I'm trisexual. I try, but I don't get it. You don't have the blues? Would you like the blues? Can you sing?
Somebody
name is. And her name is. What is your fucking name? Jim, it's a real easy name.
Why did you tell me?
Sorry. That's really your name? You're not kidding me. You said you couldn't sing, but you have a good voice. You see?
It's for my teeth.
Okay, I have something for you. And that someone is.
Red who?
Red pepper, you got a hot one?
Hey, you're looking
so good, I just got married.
Oh, that's too bad.
Not too bad, she's rich.
Hey, that's good.
Not so good, she's mean.
Oh, gee, that's too bad.
Too bad we live in a beautiful house.
Hey, that's good.
Not so good, the house burned down yesterday.
Oh, that's too bad.
Not too bad, my wife was in it. Ah! Now, let's shake hands.
What's wrong with you?
Well, that's a few. Well, that's nothing. Nothing's wrong with me.
Nothing but you. I mean, I can't believe it. I mean, how long have you been here?
About 6 feet, as long as I was over there.
Well, how long were you over there?
6 feet, as long as I am here.
Where's here?
Around.
I'll see you around.
See you around. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, exactly.
Eddie, what is wrong with you?
Nothing's wrong with me. That's up to you.
Well, if it's up to me, I'm fine.
Well, how do you, I'm Eddie?
How do you? No, you're completely misunderstood. I mean, I'm okay.
Well, I'm still Eddie.
No, I mean, I'm well.
Well, you sound sick to me. You sound like a schizophrenic. I better give you a test.
Well, that's all right by me.
See anybody next to you?
What do you mean? There's nobody next to me.
Well, maybe there's already nobody.
Well, I don't know. It could be anybody.
All right. There's nobody next to you. Anybody. Somebody will tell anybody that nobody's all right. Besides
what?
Besides, we talk English all night long. Nobody says the fucking word we say.
Besides what?
Besides who?
Besides me. I'll have to tell you, there is nobody. Nobody besides me.
There's me.
Oh, I forgot.
Oh. For song.
Ba-da-ba-da-ba-ba.
A song entitled Get Off the Stove, Granny, You're Too Old to Ride the Rain.
Or, It's So Old We Can Barely Stand Up Here to Do It.
The last time we did it.
Excuse me, my duck wants to look around.
Thank you.
Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. And now, we turn to the world of classical music, as we are about to bring on this very stage one of the finest musicians ever to come from Spain. Here, with his magical guitar, will you please welcome Mr. Manos Diplomo!
Thank you.
Klaus Mozart, Dombey, Dombey, Dombey.
Mr. Manos de Pomo will play one of the most difficult pieces ever composed for the classical guitar, written by Rimsky-Korsakov. Here is The Flight of the Bumblebee. And to display his capabilities even further, Mr. Manos de Pomo will play this piece without reading any notes.
No notes, huh? Okay, un momento. Doctor, can I have my vino, please? Okay. Un momento, por favor, I need a drink, okay? Okay. Now, okay, Toro, you want a drink? Drink. It's okay. Stradivarius won't mind.
Cables all over the place.
Okay.
Thank you.
to announce we have a very special new guest who's just arrived all the way from Bombay in India. Will you please give a warm welcome to that wonderful Indian fakir, Bumbleini. Thank you. I'm sorry he couldn't make it this evening, but we have a replacement instead. All the way from Vienna, Austria, would you welcome Dr. Professor, take your pickies both, Felix Vroom.
Lighter under finger. Well, I'm sure we've all seen that before. So I wonder what is wrong with this particular guru. Has the guru made it back yet? Yes, it's getting hot. The screaming heated finger jab. For a very kind audience. Which is more than I can say for these glasses that are pinching my nose at the moment. Now, for go lighter. The next act is called the self-inflicted hammerlock. Take hand, make into karate. Take karate, chop, smash into forehead, split body into two personalities. I split my head and I become two personalities. Hey! Hello, how are you? I'm fine, how are you? Thank you. There seems to be a bit more to the act, but I think we'll stop there.
Felix! Oh, Felix!
this guy found my boxer shorts. Phone is busy. Okay, now I am going to do the last incredible miracle. The last incredible miracle. I need my assistant, Marshall. Marshall, could you come out here, please? Thank you. Isn't he looking? He's dressed beautifully, I would say. Oh. Are you wearing boxer shorts? Okay. Now, the last incredible miracle is the breakthrough of the unbreakable plastic bag. This bag has been especially designed by the scientists at NASA, to be totally unbreakable. Yet inside the bag, you have 15 seconds of air once it's tied up. Break through the unbreakable bag. Now I know why this guru is sick. Okay. Well, I think we've all heard those instructions easy enough.
Thank you.
I'll just get inside that unbreakable bag and break through the unbreakable bag. 15 seconds of air. Unbreakable bag.
Love it.
I am Chippendale. I am Robot. Wow. Hit it. Hit it. Hit it. Wow. Chip, I can sing, I can dance, I can eat on the strip. Don't have to feed me nothing but the facts. Keep my dad clean, pay my tax. If you took me on a date, I'm a perfect boba, never homely. Program me for your desire. Push my button, play my fire. I'm a robot.
A robot.
My God, man, I'm a robot. Play the saxophone, I can play the drum. Watch me now. It's fun, I'm a robot.
Robot.
Modern kind of man, I'm a robot.
Robot.
Hard to understand, I can do things for you. Make your heart feel better. I can do good too, I can do bad. And now I'd like to bring out my little brother. My little brother, Chippendale Jr. Makes me wonder why I never learned to fly. I'm a robot.
Robot.
My kind of man. I'm a robot.
Robot.
Hard to understand. I can do things for you. Make your heart feel glad. I can do good. I can do bad. I'm a robot. Like the little boys and girls. I'm a robot.
Robot.
Wonder of this world. I can do things for you. Make your heart feel glad. I can do good. I can do bad.
Kissed it all over. Hallelujah. I love you, child. Mother Mercy.
It's so good to see you, child. Are you feeling all right? Yeah, don't be scared. I won't touch you. Hallelujah, sir. You look mighty fine today, mighty fine. One of the greatest football players of the Holland sports teams right here with us as Brute Bullet in a younger days. Yes, it's so good. Hallelujah. Look who it is. Oh, my God. Mother, have mercy on me. Sir, have you ever read the Koran?
No.
I hear it's a hell of a book, but I haven't even. Yes. You know, now you can be saved. You can be saved. All you have to do is redeem yourselves. That's what I'm doing right here. I'm redeeming myself. Scotty Gelb, huh? I can get money for myself. Hello, Brother John. How are you today? You're pretty well. Have you read the Bible today? I didn't think so. No, you haven't. Okay, John, can you take this here microphone? Because I don't need it. Thank you, brother. Yes, children, I'm here tonight. I'm here tonight to believe in the faith of sports, what sports can do for you. I'm here to tell you that, yes, I have sinned. I used the church funds for my own profit. I was playing blackjack up in the casino, and you know how they are if you don't pay. Well, I'm here to redeem myself tonight. Just like my brothers before me, Ben Johnson, Jimmy Swaggart, Oral Roberts, I have sinned. The three of those guys can talk faster than they can run because of steroids. And yes, I have taken steroids. That's why I'm so big. But you know, the Lord works in strange ways. Yes, He does. Can I have a hallelujah? Can I have an amen? Can I have a woman? Last night, when I was making love to my beautiful wife, Inga, Gabriella, I started drifting off. Can you just bring the, it's a little bit too loud, I can't concentrate. Thank you. As I was making love, I started drifting off. And the next thing I knew, I was playing football against AC Milan. All the greats were there. Ruud Gullit, Marco van Basten, Frank Rijkaard. I knew it was Frank Rijkaard because he spit in my face. The bases were loaded. There was two outs, bottom of the ninth inning. The crowd was going wild. I was pumping with the rhythm. Yes, the crowd was going wild. I was pumping with the rhythm. Suddenly, I looked up. And there was 2.8 seconds left on the time clock. Michael Jordan was double-teamed. I was alone in midfield. The pitch was high and inside. Nigel Mansell was going to pass me on a hairpin turn. I became confused. The crowd was going wild. I was pumping. I looked for the Lord for an answer. I said, Lord, what should I do? Should I swing for a home run? Should I slam Wayne Gretzky into the boards? Should I shoot a three-pointer over Magic Johnson's head? The crowd was standing on their feet. They were going wild. I was pumping with the rhythm. Suddenly, my wife turned to me and said, for God's sake, you're not my husband. And you know, children, there's a message to this story. There's a moral to be learned. And that is, never, never, under any circumstances, never, eat a shawarma with extra hot sauce right before you go to bed. And now would you all kindly turn to your hymnals to page number one. Excuse me, one. And sing along if you think you can. Once upon a time up in heaven, my children loved me, they had everything. They used to think that love was the answer, worth all the beauty. Things ain't that simple.
Life is too precious for all the people to live in our pain.
Woo!
We want to thank, this is our last show here in the Lido. We want to thank all the people in the Lido who've really supported us this year and given us the flowers, and Arnold Arson for all the work you've done for us. Thank you very much. Thank you. Stan Hayward, John Bickersteth, of course, Little Julian, I'm so young. We have to be good because my father is here, okay? So no smoking any dope, no drinking, and no smoking cigarettes, okay? Because he's American and he don't smoke cigarettes, okay? So let's all have a good time. Thanks, Dad. I love you. I love everybody. Thanks for my wonderful birthday present. You gave me more than I deserve.